Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses to get their products listed on Google and YouTube page one. I get this question very often. How do I select my Google product category for my Shopify store product? It's a really good question. What is exactly Google product category? Google product category is basically a list of terminology defined by Google of the types of products that are being sold. Let's say you could be selling apparel, you could be selling chocolates, you could be selling swimwear or skincare products. There are different category types. If you are selling skincare products, so skincare could be a broad category and it could go down to subcategories like moisturizer or serum or whitening cream. And if you're selling swimwear products, you could go down to selling bikinis or one-piece swimsuit or men's swimwear. There are different categories to each of these, and having the right category, or to be more precise, having the right subcategory linked to each of your products helps to decide if your products are going to be displayed or decided by Google to be displayed on search queries for the right set of users. Instead of letting Google do the automatic selection for your products itself, for each of your products, you want to do your own careful selection and link those information accordingly in your Shopify store. How are you going to add those product categories? I'm going to tell you in the later part of this video, but first we want to go into how to select the right Google product category. First of all, you need to go to this URL right here. I'm going to put the link down in the description and the pinned comments below where you can go to access this publicly available list. So this list could likely be updated from time to time. So if you're a new store, I would recommend you to go back to that site again and download that list to find out exactly what's the product you should associate with each of your products. So once you have one of those files, it's either in a TXT text format or an Excel. So if you don't have this Excel software, don't worry, there's a text file, so you can download it and you can see a list of categories and subcategories that Google have listed. I'm going to show you exactly how you can select one of those subcategories on your computer. So let's head on to my computer and you'll see the screen share.
This is the official Google product category page. As you can see right at the top, it says Google Merchant Center Help, and that's the URL. I will put the URL down in the pinned comments in the description so you can check it out. So let's go into some details about this product category. If you can see over here, it says the Google product category attribute is optional, meaning you can choose not to fill it in. However, as I've mentioned before, if you're not doing your own selection, Google will select it for you. And that means that Google could automatically select something that might not be 100% accurate. So you can, in this case, by you proactively coming to this resource page and selecting the right subcategory for each of your products, that's going to help you and your ranking. So let's scroll down further. So if you're running Google Shopping Ads as well, you will also be using the same resource. If you scroll down further under the format, this is where you can download either an Excel sheet or the plain text. So if you click on it, that will open up a plain text, which I'm going to do shortly. But first, I want us to examine some of this information. Google has put in an example, apparel and accessories, clothing, dresses. The subcategory here we're looking at, which is dresses. If you're selling dresses specifically, this would be the text that you will be updating in your Shopify store. There is also a corresponding ID that you can use. So for this piece of information, the ID is 2271. What you need to understand is that the more specific that you go, Google is able to show them correctly to someone who is searching for dresses. Let's look at another example further. Let's say you have a MP3 player. Looking at the example that Google has shown here, it says, use the one category that best describes your product. So for example, if you have an MP3 player, we know it doesn't really exist anymore, but still, you would use the MP3 player category, which is under electronics, audio, audio players and recorders, MP3 players. So it's very specific. You can choose either to put 233 in your Shopify Google product category field, or you can copy the entire line of text to put it in. I hope this makes sense to you. Now let's click on the file and I will show you another example. So this is the full text list of all the categories that you can refer to. Let's take a look at the previous example on MP3 players. So what I will usually do, I'll do a Control F to actually look for the MP3 players over here, which is MP3 player. So you can see over here, there are a couple of different categories type, which is ID 232, which is electronics, audio accessories. So what we are trying to look at is an MP3 player itself and not necessarily the accessories. So you can actually search further. So if you have the find function, you can go down to look at what are the different categories. You can see it. These are all accessories. Oh, and this is it, 233. So the ID for this category itself is electronics, audio players, MP3 players. That's 233. So of course there's other audio players. So if you're also selling radios, you'll be using 6886 instead. How about if you are selling something like dresses? Let's take a look at dresses for the example. So this dresses is for furniture itself. We can see, let's take a look. So there's apparel and accessories, clothing, active wear. So this is not what we're doing. Active wear is probably more like a sports category. So if you're not doing that, you wouldn't select that. And there is also further down here, which is 5424. This is baby and toddler dresses. So that's not what we're looking for. You can see if you scroll down further, there is another one that says 2271, apparel and accessories, clothing, dresses, and that's what we're looking for. I hope this is going to be helpful for you and it's going to make your job much easier.
Now that you know exactly how to select the right category for your products, the next thing you want to do is to update each of this product category for each of your product. Yes, you need to do it manually to update it in your Shopify store. Go to each of these products, like how you fill up your information, product information, and update those product categories. For you to be able to do that, first you need to go to the Shopify app store to download this Google Shopping app. Once you have that downloaded and installed properly, it will integrate with your product detail page. So you'll be able to select from a drop down to update this Google product category information. So this is a screenshot of how it's going to look like and how you can do it.
First, you head to the menu on the left, click on all products. A list of all your products will show up. Select any of it. And on the individual product page, top right hand corner, click on more actions. And Google Fields will show up. Click on Google Fields. And a dialog box is going to pop up, and there is the space where you fill up your Google product category right there. Once you have filled it up, the green save button is going to be enabled, where you can click on it and save it.
So this information that you have updated will be extracted along with your other product information to go to Google Merchant Center, so you can have your products listed on Google Shopping. Having the right Google product category will increase your chances to be displayed correctly on Google Shopping page for the right set of users who want to buy your products. So select them wisely. Don't let Google do the job for you. If you want to know exactly how to set up your Google Merchant Center account, what are the different challenges or problems you might face, you can check out my other video right here on how to resolve your Google Merchant Center account issues, if your account is suspended, and also this is another video on how to set up your products so they will get listed on Google Shopping. So do check out those videos over there, right here. I also put the links down in the comment section, the pinned comment below, so do check it out. If you found this video really useful, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you have any questions about getting your products listed on Google Shopping so more shoppers will find your products, don't forget to hit subscribe for my next video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.